Let me show you how you can automate sending push notifications to your iOS and Android devices using n8n and open source software called ntfy or simply Notify. You can use Notify in cloud, which is a great way to support this open source project, or self-host it on your own server. In this video, we will go through installation and configuration process of Notify, and we will also build a very simple workflow in n8n to automate sending push notifications. Let's get started. I will start by adding new server on Hetzner, but you can use any other provider. I will click apps to pre-install Docker on my server, and I will actually choose the cheapest option in the price list. Then basically I will just need to select my SSH key that I've created before, and I will just rename my server to make a name look a bit different in the console. After that, I can click the submit button and I will need to wait a minute to have the server properly configured. When it's done, I can copy the public IP address of my server and go to terminal to log in with SSH as a root. At this moment, I will need to create a new user, so I'm going to add the user named Oscar. I will need to enter my new password and I will need to retype it. For other fields, I will leave them blank. And finally, I will need to add the new user, which is Oscar, to sudo group. Eventually, I will log in as Oscar user and I will proceed with the installation of Notify. I will use instructions that are on the official website of Notify. So when you go to the installation tab, you can see instructions, for example, for Docker. So I will copy the Docker compose file that is stated in the documentation. Now I'm going to actually create this file on the server. So I'm using the nano editor to paste the content of Docker compose file and I'm going to save it. Now I enter the command sudo docker compose pool to actually pull the packages of Notify. And finally, I will enter the command docker compose up-d to run Notify in the background. When everything was successful, I should see the information that container has been started. As you noticed, currently when I run Docker commands, I always use sudo prefix to run them as a super user. Running them without sudo prefix may cause an error, so let's quickly fix it. If you don't have a Docker group on your server, you may need to create one by using command group add docker. But in my case, this group already exists, so I'm going to add user Oscar to this group. And after that, as you can see, when I run the Docker command without sudo, I still have an error. Basically, this means that I need to relog to my server. This time I'm going to log in as user Oscar, so I will be asked for a password because I haven't configured SSH key for this user. And eventually I can run the docker ps command, and as you can see, this time it works perfectly without sudo. I can now copy the container ID and I can investigate the logs for this one. In the output, I have the information that Notify is running successfully on port 80. I can now copy the public IP of my server and I will paste it in the browser. As you can see, we have access to Notify dashboard, so I'm going to subscribe to the topic, which I will name workflows. Basically the same operation I need to do on my iPhone. So I'm going to add the new subscription for the topic called workflows. I will also paste the URL of my server, which is basically the IP. After that, I'm ready to send the first notification. So I go back to Notify dashboard and I'm going to create a new one. As a title, I will enter the text hello, and as a message, this is just a test. After sending it, I should see the notification on the channel. The problem is that I haven't received any push notification on my iPhone. But when I refresh the view, you can see that I have one new notification in the topic, and this is the one that I've just sent from the dashboard. To actually receive push notifications, especially on iOS devices, we need to change a bit configuration of Notify. So I'm going to change the ownership of directory /etc/notify, and I'm going to add the server configuration. You can find example server file in GitHub repository of Notify, but basically from this long file, I will use only two lines. So I'm going to open file server.yml in nano editor, and I'm going to paste base URL, which is basically the URL of my instance, and upstream base URL, which is predefined to notify.sh. I'm going to save this file and I can now restart the container. For this purpose, I'm using command docker compose up-d with flag force recreate. And I can also run docker ps to actually see if the container is running properly. So I will also investigate the logs, and as you can see, notify is listening on port 80. Eventually, I can send one more push notification. So I go to notify dashboard and I send the notification with title hi and message this is another test. After sending it, I can see on my iPhone that I properly received the new notification. Perfect, everything works fine here, but we have a little problem. Currently, our instance is public, so everyone who knows the address of our notify instance can access it and send push notifications. Let's quickly change the configuration to prevent unauthorized access. I'm going to open the Docker Compose file in Nano Editor and I'm going to make some changes here. First of all, I'm going to add some environment variables. From all those variables that you can find in the notify documentation, the most important ones are basically the base URL, which is in my case the IP of my server, and the variable for enabled login. So everything will be now secured by login and password. I'll also declare the new volume to start the database of users. I can right now recreate the container, so I will enter once again command docker compose up-d with the flag force recreate. Now I need to add the user for my notify instance, so I will run command docker ps to actually know my container ID, and after that I will run command docker exec for this container ID to add the user. Within the container, I run the command notify user add with role admin, and I will name the user Oscar. I will enter the password and I will confirm the password. Eventually, I receive the information that user has been created. Now, when I go to the notify dashboard and try to publish the new push notification, I will receive an error that the access has been forbidden. So basically, right now I need to click the sign in button and enter my username and password. I will create a new topic and I will also name it workflows. The difference is that right now it will be secured by login and password, both in the dashboard and in the API. After creating the topic, I can send the example push notification. So in this case, it will be with title hello and message auth test. After sending it, I can move to my iPhone. In the Notify app on iPhone, I've already configured the default host, which in my case is IP of Notify. I will add the new subscription to topic workflows, and I will be automatically asked for the login and password. After adding both of those data, I will see that I already have some notifications on my subscription. In this final step, I'm about to build a very simple n8n workflow to send AI-generated welcome message as a push notification. First, I will go to my n8n dashboard and I will create here a new blank workflow. I will rename it to push notifications and I will also rename the entry node, which is basically the manual execution node. After that, in the nodes library in n8n, I'm going to search for OpenAI node and I will simply put it on the canvas. My goal here is to generate a simple welcome message with OpenAI. So I'm going to choose the model. In my case, it's going to be GPT-4o mini. And I'm going to enter the prompt. So I will enter, write a short welcome message, use emojis and max 5 words. In the output, I receive a message, which in this case is welcome, enjoy your stay. It's not the best one, but we can use it for the testing purposes. Eventually, I'm going to search for HTTP request node, and this one will be responsible for actually posting the push notification. So I'm going to rename it to send notification, and I will go back to notify dashboard. Here, I'm going to copy the CURL of my instance, and I'm going to paste it to HTTP request node. Since we have enabled the authentication, I also need to add the credentials. So I will add the basic authentication and I will rename my credentials to notify. As a user, I enter the username and also I enter the password. Finally, I can save the credentials. Next, I can configure the content of my push notification. So first, I'm going to add the header. In this case, I'm going to add the title, which will have the value hello. As a body of my push notification, I will add the message from OpenAI. The little difference here is that I'm going to change the body content type to raw, and I'm going to enter content type text HTML. As a body, I'm going to add the expression to take the values from the previous node, which is basically the output from OpenAI. After executing this node, you can see that in the notify dashboard, I have properly added the notification, and I also can see it on my iPhone. With Notify, you can create also more advanced push notifications, and you can see all the configuration possibilities in Notify documentation. For each option, you can see on which platform it's supported. You can see the icons, for example, for iOS or Android. Right now, I'm going to add the click action. So after clicking the notification, I should be redirected to the specific website. For this purpose, I need to add the click header. So I go back to the HTTP request node, and I'm going to add the new header with name click, and the value will be the workflow's website, which is basically my website. After test execution of this workflow, I can go back to Notify dashboard, and as you can see, I have here a new notification with two options. The first one is copy link and the second one is open link. After clicking open link, I'm redirected to my website. The same works also for mobile. As you can see, I received the notification, and after clicking this one, I'm redirected to Safari with opened tab of workflows.com. With combination of Notify and n8n, you can build a very cool infrastructure for sending push notifications about certain events or errors in your workflows. Possibilities here are very broad. Hope you find this video helpful. If you like it, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel and to my newsletter, link like always in the description, and see you very soon. Bye.